Everyone, it's me, Princess Savannah Sims, and we are back with episode 17 of Love and Loss, and we are here with Katie Kogan and Salvatore Kogan. We know who Chester is, but who's Salvatore? You guys, I am having the glitches of all glitches in this game. It is so unreal how glitched this neighborhood is. It's going crazy. It's going wild. I don't know where this baby came from. Obviously, Trisha didn't have a child, and now Katie's too old to have a child. So, let me see. Okay, yeah. Only Salvatore. No, she gave birth to Chester. Oh my gosh. Well, whatever. Alright, we are back with Janet Brown. Just checking on her. And the boys have grown up. Simon, Paxton, Brennan, and Terrence, number two. Was just checking on them to see how they're doing. But now that they have grown into children, I will need to change their room a bit. So excuse me, Terrence number two. I'm gonna ask you to just go over there real quick so I can add the beds. I'm just gonna keep it real simple, you guys. Just adding some beds. I'm not going to do too much. She doesn't even have enough room for too much. So let's sell these cribs. And okay. It's in the wrong spot. That always messes me up. Okay, yes. I'm gonna do two of the green beds. And then two of the rock and roll beds. Is that it? Should I just keep it that simple? Let me see. What else can I add? I think that's it. Yeah, I don't. Again, too many kids, not enough room. Alright, you guys, I'm checking on Mackenzie, well, mostly Grayson. You guys, Mackenzie is pregnant again. Oh my goodness. Who is the lucky guy? Ricky! Who is her boyfriend? Didn't I warn Ricky about her? I specifically warned him about her. Now she has three different kids by three different men. But anyway, look at Grayson, all grown up. A teenager. Alright, you guys. So I'm going to take you guys along with me as I redecorate this house. Maxwell house. Well, let's start downstairs. So as I said in a previous video, the house is very bare. Like, they really have nothing in it. So we're just gonna fill it up a little bit. Just fluff it up. Nothing too crazy. I'm gonna leave the kitchen alone because I think the kitchen is good. But for this dining area, let's see. What am I looking for? I'm looking for like those accents that I'll see it when I'm I mean I know I'll know it when I see it. I do want like a tall flower pot, but let me I like this. Ooh, and it goes in the corner. We put it in this corner right over here. Okay. And then, yeah, let me get two of these. I think that looks very fancy. And then I'm looking for that huge flower pot that flower pot. So give me a second. It's gonna take me a minute. I think that's here. If you hear that noise, that's my neighbors upstairs just running around like a bunch of animals. So I apologize for that. No, I need something bigger. I want something that actually sits down on the ground. Everything looks so big in the picture, so I'm thinking it's gonna. Ah, here it is. Here it is. Alright. But. Let me see. Let me get that red, right? To blend in with the wall. Oh, that's perfect. Yeah. Because it's even better, because we have that pop of color. I mean, of course, the walls are red. And we have the white. But then we have that extra pop of color as soon as you come in. I think that looks real good. Now it looks fuller. It looks like a complete dining room. It needs a painting. So definitely want one against this wall here. And then that's it. Just one painting. I don't want to take away from the framing that is on the walls. That whole framing design. I actually have something like that in my apartment right now. But my apartment isn't painted, so. And yeah, that one. Okay. Alright. I already got one room down. Dining room is set. Go to the. What about this little area behind the staircase? What should I put there? I don't know. Anyway, let's focus on the living room. The good thing is there are plenty of lights, you guys. This place is well lighted, so we don't have to worry about that. But I definitely want a huge rug. Like a nice big rug. So let's see. Oh, that is huge. That is huge. I think that color will go great. I know the walls are beige, but you see the rug has that tint of beige. It's like that white beige color. And I like these booths that came with, you know, the dinette. The only issue was the tables. But they got one without the tables, but I don't... Then it'll have like that high back, and I don't want that. Okay, yes. Look at that. All the contrasting colors. And it's not gonna be dull. We're not gonna make this some dull beige living room. It's gonna look nice. Now, should I leave this couch so close? Like a island type thing? I wanna move it back. Definitely wanna move it back, because I definitely want to showcase, you know, the rug and I think I'm in the wrong part. You know how they have the whole collection? So I'm looking for the... there it is. Okay. There we go. Alright. I think it's coming together nicely. Now for a coffee table. Get this in a nice brown. Make it like that dark piece in the middle. No music. Like a nice sculpture. Milk jug, a brand? No. Oh wow. Will this work? Let me see. It looks crazy. it looks crazy. No. But I do. Oh, I want this. Yes. Just one more facing the opposite way. Come on. Yes. That's better. And then just a little something by the windows. A seating area. It's a little low in the back, but I think that works. Ooh. It needs a plant, you guys. I would have put plants on the table, but I think putting it underneath the TV looks really good. But let's change the color to that nice tan brown. There we go. And then anything else? More sculptures. What about this fountain? That was huge. I don't think that'll work there. Then it'll look too cluttered. Forget it. I'm just gonna leave that space alone. But let me add the computer desk. I think that'll be good. I have another idea for that area right there. I think that looks good. Yeah. This little bathroom here is fine, just the way it is. Dining room's done. Alright, so let's go upstairs. And there is a second bathroom up here. It looks good. I'm gonna leave it alone. Like, I don't want to make too much of a fuss. I just wanted to make it not so empty. I don't want too big of a rug like I had in the living room. So, I do like this rose. Oh, that's nice. Put that there. Okay. That looks good. And then add, some end tables. I think the solid ones work well with the bed. Put a little clock just for show. You know, they don't really need an alarm clock. Yeah, just a mini one. I don't want to go crazy with the floor plants. And then like a little, just a little photo. This one here. Oh yeah, that blends in with the wall. Just one. Or do I see another? I think that's it. Now I'm looking for something for the dresser. It's like this stack of books. This one? No. It was like, here it is. The vintage books, yeah. That's it. I think this room is good to go. Alright. I want to put a runner here. Yeah, that's a good size. That's a pretty color. Look at that. Even though the walls have that block texture and the runner has the flower texture, it still meshes together. And then we put a mat in front of the door. Maybe this one? Texture? Yeah, it looks good. I know it's looking like the beige home, but it's not boring. But I'd be perfect for this one. This one, yes. Make it a little. Turn it this way. I like that. Okay. Now for this little room here, we're gonna make it into a library. The reason being, it can't be a bedroom because it has the balcony out there. So it needs to be like a little private recreational type room. Like a study room, but without the computer. So let me, like this one. This one's cool. Put that there. And then an easel. And then definitely 3 comfortable chairs. Yes. Okay. And then a little rug. These rugs, they bring out the whole room. I do like this one. How's that look? Nice peach rose tan. Alright, so this wallpaper has like animals. Let's pick a different, I like the green, but let's pick a different green. Now this one has diamonds on it. I'm gonna have to go back to pink. I'm sure there's an easier way to do this. But every time I do like the whole room, somehow the paint or color or whatever goes into another room. Because either I don't see that room is connected and like there's no closing, so instead of me risking it, I'll just do it the long way. Alright, and that is that. I think that looks really good. It's simple, Not too crazy. Sorry, the camera's going everywhere. All right, now for their bedroom. They have a white black going on. So I definitely want to continue that. Let's get them. Real good. I'm sure you guys are gonna be like, no, not the black. Trust me, this is gonna look really good. Oh, look at that. Matching with the walls. Perfect. Alright, let's get a little. I like things to be symmetric. Nice. Yeah, that is perfect. And then the same one. Both sides of the bed. See what these curtains look like. This one looks good, but I don't know because of the way that, like the round windows and then the rectangle windows. I think it's fine on its own. Like, it has its own character, so I think that curtains are gonna ruin the whole thing. What would be nice in this corner is a desk. Not with a computer, just like something that's a drafting. Yes, this one. Black and white, and then a black chair, and that's it. That's all it needs. And that is really good. All right, so their bedroom is complete. The second floor is complete. I want to get, where is it, the chess table. I don't think that'll fit out there with the chairs and all that. We have all these balconies. Let's use them. Use it on this balcony. Let me get everything focused here. Okay. Plenty of room. Do I have like the outside chair? Those are the stairs. I'm looking like for a specific chair. Will this work? That'll work. Whatever. I was looking for like that plasticky chair. Let's add some bar stools to our bar. Nice blue, black and blue. Okay, that's real good. And a little bit deeper out into the backyard. Still have the setup from the wedding, so I'm just gonna spread out these benches. I'm not gonna get rid of them. This backyard is huge. I would put a pool, but I think it's gonna ruin the whole thing. I think it's fine just the way it is. Maybe, maybe I will in the future if I get sick of it like that. Let's put a grill. I'm gonna keep the trellis where it's at. Let's just put it over here. And now for the table. This one. Colors they got for this. Ooh. Oh. I want the red. We need something that pops in this backyard. Alright, now I'm definitely going to be a little picky about these chairs. Let me see. This one. Oh, yes. Yes, that works out perfectly. You guys, we are complete. We are complete. I don't think there's nothing else that needs to happen to this house. Alright, we are done. Thank you so much for watching episode 17 of Love and Loss. Again, my name is Princess Savannah Sims. And I'll see you guys in the next video.